Hello and welcome back. Imperial Assault Week continues here on What's Inside, and today we're looking at Jabba's Realm expansion. Obviously, this involves Jabba Hutt, and is on Tattooing. It's pretty cool. It's supposed to come with a Rancor monster. The picture looks awesome. And there's a whole bunch of cards and other stuff in here. So let's dig into this and see what we got. This is by Fantasy Flight. You do need the regular Imperial Assault game to play because it incorporates all that. There are 16 minis. It's for ages 14, 2 to 5 players, 1 to 2 hours. There's a whole bunch of stuff, so this could be a long one. Buckle in, kids. And this is another piece of my buddy Wyatt's big Imperial Assault haul, so thanks to him for letting me open this up before he gets a chance to. And let's see what we got here. Alright, box is pretty sturdy. Alright, we got our usual catalog for Fantasy Flight Games. Alright, then we got a rule book. This is nice and thick. Probably lots of missions in here. On the back is a sheet you can photocopy. It's got all the mission stuff and campaign log. Let's see what we got inside here. Yeah, nice and colorful. Lots of layouts. Lots of missions. Lots of missions. Pretty cool. The art is solid as always. Then we've got a skirmish map sheet. This uses pieces from this map and the core box, of course. On the other side, we have a large Borderlands map for skirmishing. Uses tons of tiles. This is a huge map. Then we've got some stickers. Ooh, stickers. They're numbered 19 and 20 for some reason. All right, there's our tiles. We've got a big pile of miniatures. Oh, that's actually kind of heavy. And we've got a whole bunch of cards. Cool. So let's double check underneath the cardboard, make sure nothing's hiding under there. No mysteries we're missing out on. All right. Get that out of the way. Let's look at the minis first, like always. Oh, there's so many of them in here. Wow! Holy crap! That Rancor is huge! Wow, that is nice. Very detailed, too. Look at that. The detailing on that is great. Look how big those arms are. You could easily hold one of the regular minis. It's probably 100 centimeters, I'd guess. And he just snaps together, which I really like because I'm super lazy. Then we've got this girl in Mandalorian armor. Pretty nice. She's holding a sword. I'd be a little worried about that breaking off. Then there's some walrus man looking guy. I don't know what Walrus Man's real name is. I'm old. I don't care. Then there's this Greedo-looking guy. Whatever that race is. The fish people race. Got some Gamorrean guards. There's a trooper with a jetpack. It's got a little flying stand for him, too. There's some, six little flying stand pegs and a couple of bases here. Looks like four bases. And we see three flyers, four, maybe, yeah, four flyers. There's a Weequay looking guy from the skiff. I don't know what that guy's name is, but he's pretty cool looking. Another Gamorrean guard. Another Weequay guy. His little staff thing's bent. That's one thing I worry about with these is the, like, this one's got a bent staff. Hard to show on camera there. That these will get damaged. Because, you know, I'm hesitant to try and straighten that out. I'll let Wyatt do that. But, yeah, I'd be worried about that. But, yeah, lots of minis. The Rancor looks really cool. That is a real solid piece too. Good detailing, lots of flesh scale. Very good detailing, very heavy. It'll hold up pretty well, I think. Yeah, pretty sweet. The mouth is a separate piece from the jaw, so or the upper jaw. So it goes together pretty nice. Very detail oriented. I really like the Rancor. That looks really cool. All right, yeah, that's the minis. They do look really awesome. I'll give them credit for that. They've managed to pull it off. The flying troopers look really cool too. They have kind of the pilot helmets, if you remember from the movies like New Hope. They have the TIE fighter helmets, so they look pretty cool. Yeah, I dig those little jetpacks. You'd be all Rocket Man. So yeah, the minis look awesome. Real nice quality. I am a little worried about these staff guns. Like, this one's bent, like I said. But other than that, that's kind of the only fear I would have with some of these is the sword on this girl. That'd be about it. But yeah, the little flying bases are pretty nice. The regular bases are, of course, great. Rancor looks fantastic. I would buy it just for the Rancor, honestly. Because that is a really cool mini. I'd display that, if nothing else. Alright, let's get these back in the box so they're out of my way. Alright, let's look at the tiles quick. Alright, these are tiles SWI32. This is A1 of 3. I got a couple of decent sized tiles and a couple of small ones. Some other little bits. The back is this kind of desert, dusty scene leading probably to Jabba's lair. This is side B. Looks pretty nice. The quality is real good, as always. Alright, here is sheet number 2 of 3. We got what looks like a, I don't know, underground maybe? Marshy kind of look. Swampy. The little brook bridge looks pretty cool. There's Jabba and a guy on a dewback and Luke Skywalker and a couple of look like rebel soldiers. There's some condition markers and some other markers. Let's look at the other side. More. Oh, there's the Sarlacc. That's pretty cool. And there's Jabba, what looks like a Jabba the Hutt. I don't know if that's supposed to be a statue or if that's where Jabba sits. That's pretty cool. Alright, let's look at the third set of tiles here. Alright, we got a little Salacious Crumb over there, which I really hope there's a miniature for him in one of the packs, because that would be funny. And looks like some Imperial area there. Yeah, pretty cool. The Sarlacc pit could have been bigger, but that'd be my main complaint, is that it doesn't look like the Sarlacc is like fully developed as a card. I think that should be a bigger piece. But I don't know, maybe it works fine. They're really nice tiles. The art is pretty stellar on these, so I'm not going to complain too much. Alright, let's get to our character cards. Alright, we're going to experience a quick cut while I zoom in. Alright, so first we have this girl. Shayla Varad, daughter of Mandalore. She's wearing Mandalorian armor. That's pretty cool. So, Mandalorian whip, deplete, One exhaust, choose a small hostile figure within three spaces in line of sight. Push that figure up to three spaces to an adjacent space next to you. Then perform an attack with a melee weapon targeting that figure. Respite. At the end of your activation, if you are not adjacent to a hostile figure, recover one exhaustion. Health 12, endurance 4, speed 5, defense of one black die, punchy symbol of two blue and one green. Eyeball test of two green. Robot claw, one blue, one yellow. Now let's look at the back of her card. Mandalorian whip, deplete, one exhaustion. Choose a small hostile figure within three spaces in line of sight. Push that figure up to three spaces to a space adjacent to you. Then perform an attack with a melee weapon targeting that figure. Health 12, endurance 3, speed 4, defense 1 black die. Punchy 2 red, or, I'm sorry, 2 blue, 1 red. Eyeball 1 red, 1 green. Robot claw 1 blue, 1 red. So she looks like she's okay. Then we have Vinto Rita, Reckless Vigilante. This is the Greedo looking guy. Bolt Slinger, after you resolve an attack with a blaster weapon or pistol, if the target suffered damage, you may choose another hostile figure in your line of sight and within three spaces of you. That figure suffers one damage. Thread the Needle, one exhaustion. Used during your activation, figures do not block your line of sight during this activation. Health 11, endurance 4, speed 4, defense of one white die. Punch of one green, eyeball, one blue, two green, robot claw, one red, one yellow. Then the back of his card is Bolt Slinger. After you resolve an attack with a blast weapon, if the target suffered damage, you may choose another hostile figure in your line of sight and within three spaces of you, that figure suffers one damage. Health 11, endurance 3, speed 3, defense of one white die. Punch of one red die. Eyeball of one blue, one red, one green. Robot claw test at two red. Then we have Onar Koma, Furious Bodyguard. That's the Walrus Man guy. Rush. When you enter a space adjacent to a small figure, you may push that figure up to one space. Limit once per activation. Power through. You cannot gain harmful conditions. When you rest, you recover two additional damage. You can rest only once per activation. Health of 20. Endurance 4. Speed 4. No defense. Wow. Punch of 1 blue, 2 yellow. Eyeball of 1 green, 1 yellow. Robot claw of 1 blue, 1 red. Now, his damage side. Rush. When you enter a space adjacent to a small figure, you may push that figure up to one space. Limit once per activation. Power through. When you rest, you recover two additional damage. Health 20, endurance 3, speed 3, no defense. Punch of one blue, one yellow, and one red. Eyeball of one red, one green. Robot claw of two red. Alright, so he's pretty tough. No defense, but he's kind of a beast. Alright, so that's our big cards. Let's get these out of the way, and then we'll look at all those little cards. There's quite a few again. Alright, what I really like about this game is you really do get the value for the dollar. I haven't had a chance to play it yet, but what I'm seeing so far is pretty impressive. And it does look like it is worth what you're paying for it. So, yeah, I won't be too disappointed by whatever you pay for it. Alright, we'll start with the character cards, but let me divvy the cards up into stacks so that it'll make it a little faster for me. There's a lot of cards here. There's a pretty decent number of item cards, too. Ooh, there's some Jabba the Hutt cards, some Darth Vader cards. Oh, there's a little bit of everything. A little bit of everything! Ooh, lots of command cards, too. Alright. So let's start with the Greedo-looking guy. Since he's on the bottom here. Hair trigger pistol. Blaster pistol. Surge of plus one damage. Surge of plus two accuracy. While attacking with this weapon, you may re-roll all of your attack dice. The attack is blaster, one blue, one yellow. Let me kind of zoom in a little bit more here. If I can. Alright, pinpoint shot. One XP. Exhaust this card while attacking with a blaster weapon to remove all damage, defense, surge, cancel, and dodge results. Then apply plus one damage to the attack results. The attack gains weaken. No abilities can modify the results further. Shoot on a shot on the run. Apply plus one speed to your hero. 1 XP. Exhaust this card if you're if you've performed a move during this activation and choose a hostile figure within 3 spaces and line of sight. Test eyeball. If you succeed, that figure suffers 1 damage. Sharpshooter, 2 XP, plus 1 accuracy. Bolt slinger, shot on the run and rapid fire can each affect hostile figures within 4 spaces. Battlefield experience, 2 XP. Apply plus one endurance to your hero. Exhaust this card while attacking to reroll one attack die. Offhand blaster, 3 XP. Blaster pistol, attack of one blue die. Pierce one. Surge plus one damage. One exhaustion. Exhaust this card during your activation to perform an attack using this weapon. Dead on, 3 XP. Exhaust this card while attacking to apply a plus one blast to the attack results. Exhaust this card when you use Bolt Slinger. The chosen hostile figure suffers one additional damage. Exhaust this card when you use Pinpoint Shot. The target suffers one damage. Rapid Fire, 4 XP, 1 exhaustion. Exhaust this card during your activation. Each hostile figure within 3 spaces and line of sight suffers one damage. While attacking with a blaster weapon, you may reroll all attack dice and defense dice. Merciless, 4 XP. Exhaust this card while attacking a figure who has suffered damage. Apply plus 3 damage to the attack results. That's pretty nice. Alright, so that is his cards. Let's get those out of the way. Put those face down over here. Now let's check the girls, or the lady. The Mandalorian lady. Duelist's Blade. Melee attack of one green, one yellow. Blade, surge plus one damage. Surge, pierce one. Deplete, replace one yellow die in your attack pool with one red die, and then perform an attack with this weapon. Responsiveness. Exhaust this card at the start of your activation to gain one movement point. Exhaust this card at the start of your activation to recover one exhaustion. It only costs a point. All-out attack, 1 XP. Exhaust this card while performing while attacking with a melee weapon to apply plus 1 damage and negative 1 surge to the attack results. Smoke Bombs. Accessory, 2 XP. 1 exhaustion. Exhaust this card at the end of your activation and choose a figure within 3 spaces. If that figure is friendly, it becomes hidden. If not, it becomes weakened. Proximity Strike, 2 XP. Exhaust this card while attacking with a melee weapon. You may force the defender to reroll one defense die of your choice. Then you may reroll one attack die. Swords Dance, 3 XP. 1 exhaustion. Exhaust this card after you resolve an attack with a melee weapon, remove one die from your attack pool, and perform an attack with the same weapon and target. Remote Detonator Accessory, 3 XP. 1 exhaustion. Exhaust this card during your activation and choose a hostile figure within 3 spaces. Roll one green die. That figure suffers damage equal to the damage results. Full sweep, 4 XP. Exhaust this card while attacking with a melee weapon. The attack gains cleave, 3 damage. Finally, Deadly Grace, 4 XP. Apply plus 1 endurance to your hero. Plus 1 cancel. At the start of your activation, gain 2 movement points. And that's all her cards. So move those down a little bit. And we'll check out the Walrus Man looking guy's cards. Bodyguard Rifle. Blaster Rifle. Attack of Blaster 1 green, 1 red. When you declare an attack with this weapon, you may apply negative 1 damage and plus 2 accuracy to the attack results. Keep Up. 1 XP. Exhaust this card at the end of an activation to gain 1 movement point. Get Down, 1 XP. Exhaust this card while you or another friendly figure within 2 spaces is defending. Test Punchy or Eyeball. If you pass the punch test, apply plus 1 defense to the results. If you pass the eyeball test, apply plus 1 cancel to the defense results. Stay Behind Me, 2 XP. Apply plus 2 health to your hero. While an adjacent friendly figure is defending, if you are healthy, you may suffer 1 damage to apply plus 1 defense to the defense results. 2 XP isn't bad. Mutual Destruction, 2 XP. While attacking, you may suffer 1 damage to apply plus 1 damage to the attack results. Exhaust this card when you use Rush. You and the pushed figure each suffer 1 damage. Brute Strength, 3 XP. When you perform a Robot Claw or Eyeball test, you may use your Punch attribute instead. Exhaust this card when you perform an Interact test Strength or Fisty. If you receive 2 or more successes, perform that Interact without using an action. Hold Still, 3 XP. Exhaust this card while an adjacent hostile figure is defending to apply negative 1 defense or negative 1 cancel to the defense results. When a hostile figure voluntarily exits an adjacent space, you become focused. Black Sun Armor, 4 XP, plus 3 health. Wow, that makes him a real beast. When defending, you may apply plus 1 defense or plus 1 cancel to the defense results. Considering he's got 20 XP, that's pretty freaking good. Don't Make Me Hurt You, 4 XP. Exhaust this card when you declare an attack to add 1 red die to your attack pool. After you resolve an attack, if the target was defeated, you may suffer 1 damage to ready this card. Alright, so that's all his. That's pretty good. Those guys look pretty good overall. I think the big guy is probably my favorite so far. Alright, let's take a look at these cards with the crate symbol on them. Painkillers, Medical. While wounded, you gain plus 1 speed and plus 1 endurance. During your activation, if you are healthy, you may give this card to an adjacent hero. Flash Bomb, Consumable Explosive. 2 Exhaustion. Choose a space within 3 spaces. Each figure on or adjacent to the chosen space suffers 1 damage and becomes weakened. Pit Droid. Droid. Place the Pit Droid companion in your space. The Pit Droid activates at the start or end of your activation. Oh, that's cool. You could get a little sidekick. Alright, since we're on those, let's look at the equipment cards here. Let's start with the number ones. First we have Hand Cannon. Blaster Pistol. Attack. Blaster. 2 red die. Plus 1 accuracy. When you declare an attack with this weapon, you may apply negative 1 damage and plus 2 accuracy to the attack results. 400 credits. Back to Pump, Accessory. At the start of your activation, recover 1 exhaustion or discard a harmful condition. 300 credits. Emergency Injector, Accessory. Deplete this card during your activation. You or an adjacent friendly figure recovers 2 exhaustion and discards a harmful condition. 150 credits. That's not too bad. Alright, let's look at the number 2s. We got 3 of those. Double Vibro Sword. Blade. Attack melee 1 green, 1 red. Surge cleave 2 damage. Surge pierce 1. One exhaustion, after you resolve an attack with this weapon, each adjacent hostile figure suffers one damage. 650 credits. Energized Hilt. Modification, Energy. Exhaust this card when you declare an attack. Replace one die in your attack pool with one die of your choice. 250 credits. Bolt Upgrade. Modification, Energy. Exhaust this card when you declare an attack. Replace one die in your attack pool with one attack die of your choice. 250 credits. Alright, now the number threes. Ryak Blades. Attack, melee, question marks. Your attack pool with this weapon is your punch pool. While attacking with this weapon, you may convert any number of surge results to damage results. 950 credits. Modified energy cannon, blaster rifle, attack, 3 question marks. Surge plus 1 damage, plus 2 accuracy. Your attack pool with this weapon is your robot claw pool. While attacking with this weapon, you may reroll one attack die. 1,000 credits. Oh, both those are kind of cool. 3 dice of random damage. Admiral's Uniform. Armor. Plus 1 health. Exhaust this card after a rebel figure within 3 spaces rolls any number of dice. That figure may reroll any number of those dice. 350 credits. Cool. Let's check the condition cards. Alright, we got Weakened. While attacking, apply -1 surge to the attack results. While defending, apply -1 cancel to the defense results. Discard this condition at the end of your activation. And there are 4 of those. All 4 of them are Weakens. Alright, let's look at these yellow ones. Sunshiny yellows. Alright, we have a pit droid. Droid, useful. You can retrieve crates. Adjacent heroes can interact with crates you are carrying. Shiny. If you are on the map at the end of the mission, heroes gain 50 credits. Health 3, speed 4, defense of 1 white die, no attack. Salacious B. Crumb, brawler. Alright. Swipe. When you activate in or enter a space containing a hostile figure, it suffers 1 damage. Limit once per figure per round. Exhaust Scratch. Choose an adjacent hostile figure. That figure suffers 1 damage. Health 6, speed 3, no attack or defense. I still want a mini of him. Alright, let's check these green cards here. Hidden. These are all hidden markers, apparently. And they're all the same, so you're going to have 4 of the same card. While defending, apply -2 accuracy to the attack results. While attacking, apply +1 surge to the attack results. After you resolve an attack, you must discard this condition. Alright, let's look at the command cards. Alright, we have Blade Storm. Shayla Varad. 1. While attacking to apply +1 surge to the attack results. After the attack resolves, each hostile figure within 2 spaces of you suffers 1 damage. Extra Protection. Onar Koma. That's the Walrus Man guy. 1. When another friendly figure within 2 spaces suffers 3 or more damage, move up to 2 spaces, then perform an attack. Draw. Vinto Herida, which is the Greedo-looking guy. 1. Use during your activation to perform an attack without using an action. Glory of the Kill, Hunter. 1. Use after you resolve an attack targeting a figure. If the defender was defeated, recover 3 damage. Toxic Dart, 0. Hunter or Smuggler. Use during your activation, a hostile figure within 3 spaces and in line of sight suffers 1 exhaustion and becomes weakened. Pickpocket, Smuggler, 1. Use during your activation while adjacent to a hostile figure to roll 1 green die. Your opponent loses VPs and you gain VPs equal to the accuracy results. That's fun. Run for Cover, Smuggler, 2. Use when an attack targeting you is declared. Choose 1 die and remove it from the attack pool. Tools for the job, hunter or smuggler, 2. Use when you declare an attack to add one attack die of your choice to the attack pool. Stimulants, smuggler, 0. Exhaust, you or an adjacent figure suffers 1 damage, then gains 1 movement point and becomes focused. On the lamb, smuggler, 3. While defending, before the attack applies modifiers to interrupt to perform a move. Alright, so those look pretty cool. Now let's look at the Jabba the Hutt cards here. Let's see what we got here. 1 to dead. When no heroes have a bounty token, each hero claims a bounty token. Exhaust this card while a hero with a bounty token is defending to apply +1 damage or +1 surge to the results. When a hero with a bounty token is defeated, discard that token. Hutt Mercenaries. Vendetta, 1 XP. Exhaust this card while a hero with a bounty token is defending to reroll 1 attack die. While attacking, an Imperial figure could spend 1 surge to ready this card. Scouted, 1 XP. Exhaust this card while a hero with a bounty token is attacking to reroll 1 defense die. If you do, convert all dodge results to cancel results. While choosing open groups for missions, ignore the no mercenaries figures restriction. Savage Motivation, 2 XP. Exhaust this card during an Imperial figure's activation and choose an adjacent rebel figure. Roll 1 yellow die. That figure suffers damage equal to the damage results. If the Imperial figure is a mercenary figure, roll 1 blue die instead. Cheap Shot, 2 XP. Exhaust this card during an Imperial figure's activation and choose an adjacent hostile figure. That figure may test punch. If he does not pass, it becomes weakened. If the Imperial figure is a mercenary figure, apply -1 surge to the test results. Nowhere to Run, 3 XP. Exhaust this card when an attack targeting a hero who has suffered 3 or more exhaustion is declared to apply +1 damage to the attack results. If the attacker is a mercenary figure, apply an additional +1 damage to the attack results. Nowhere to Hide, 3 XP. Exhaust this card before an attack targeting hero with a bounty token is declared. Figures do not block line of sight for this attack, and you add 1 blue die to the attack pool. Guild Hunters. When you deploy a mercenary figure, that figure becomes hidden. This one's 4 XP, by the way. Imperial figures gain Surge +1 damage, +2 accuracy, Surge Pierce 2, Surge Hide. Most Wanted, 4 XP. Exhaust this card while a hero is defending to apply +2 damage to the attack results. If that hero has a bounty token, apply an additional +1 damage to the attack results. Alright, let's look at the Vader cards here. Let's see what we've got there. Alright, these are all labeled Nemesis. So we got Powerful Foes. You earn 1 Imperial symbol and 1 mercenary villain of your choice. So 1 Imperial and 1 mercenary villain of your choice. Alright, after choosing open groups, add 1 earned villain to your hand of open groups. 1 Imperial symbol. Deplete this card when you deploy a villain to reduce its deployment cost by the threat level. Inspirational. Exhaust this card when a figure declares an attack to choose a villain on the map or reveal a villain in your open or reserved groups. During this attack, non-villain Imperial figures that share a trait with the chosen or revealed villain gain +1 surge and +1 cancel. Fearsome Presence, 1 XP. Exhaust this card at the end of your activation. Each rebel figure adjacent to an Imperial figure with a cost equal to or greater than the threat level suffers 1 exhaustion for each activation token he has. Prepare the Ambush, 1 XP. When it is your turn to activate a group, you may exhaust this card instead of activating a group. At the start of its activation, each figure in the first Imperial group to activate each round gains 2 movement points. I'm on the Leader, 2 XP. Exhaust this card while an Imperial figure is attacking the healthy hero who has suffered the least damage. Apply +2 damage to the attack results. Ringleader, attachment, 2 XP, villain only. At the start of your activation, you gain 2 movement points. While an adjacent friendly figure is attacking, apply +1 accuracy and +2 damage to the attack results. Punishing Force, 3 XP. Exhaust this card while an Imperial figure is attacking to reroll any number of attack dice. Ready this card at the end of each Rebel activation. Leave them to me, 3 XP. After choosing open groups, add 1 earned villain to your hand of open groups. Deplete this card when you deploy a villain to reduce that villain's deployment cost by 5. Exhaust that villain's deployment card. Indomitable, 4 XP. Villains cannot receive harmful conditions. Exhaust this card when an attack targeting a villain is declared to add 1 black die to that villain's defense pool. 1 Imperial symbol. Use an attack targeting a villain is declared to ready this card. Devastating Legion, 4 XP. When a rebel figure within 3 spaces of a villain is defending, you may apply -1 defense or -1 cancel to the defense results. And now lastly, we've got the rewards cards. We have Mandalorian Heritage. Reward, apply +2 health to your hero. Before you declare an attack with a melee weapon, you may have the attack gain 1 of the following. Surge +2 damage, Surge recover 2 damage, Reach. Desperado Reward, exhaust this card while attacking. For each hostile figure within 3 spaces of you, apply +1 Surge to the attack results. Exhaust this card while defending. For each hostile figure within 3 spaces of you, apply +1 cancel to the defense results. Haymaker Reward, 1 Exhaustion. Exhaust this card during your activation and choose an adjacent small hostile figure. Test Punchy. For each success, a maximum of 3, push that figure up to 1 space and that figure suffers 1 damage. Bread for War Reward. Return this card to the game box when you deploy a Rancor. Reduce its deployment cost by 4 and it becomes focused. Alright, so there's some pretty cool cards here. Really adds a lot to the overall game. And I think it's going to really add a lot to the missions that are on here. So there's some cool options. Let's put these away, move them aside, and look at the other ones. Alright, big cards. We got, oh, there's a bunch of missions. Look at all these cards. Oh, there's a lot of those. Alright. Let's start with the Imperial Agenda cards. We've got Call Your Shot, 2 influence. Keep this card secret. Play it during any mission while a figure is defending to apply -1 dodge or -3 defense to the defense results. Then discard this card. Shoot First, 2 influence. Keep this card secret. Play it during any mission at the start of a round. An Imperial group may interrupt to perform an activation. Then discard this card. Abandoned Contract, 2 influence. Keep this card secret. Play it during any mission at the start of a round. During this round, Imperial figures corresponding to a deployment card gain deplete increase Imperial by 2, then you are defeated. Then either discard this card or shuffle it into your agenda deck. Snapfire, 2 influence. Keep this card secret. Play it during any mission when a rebel figure enters a space within 3 spaces of an Imperial figure. That Imperial figure may interrupt to perform an attack targeting that rebel figure. Then either discard this card or shuffle it into your agenda deck. No Rest for the Weary, 1 influence. Place this card in your play area. When a hero performs a rest, an Imperial figure may interrupt to perform a move. At the end of any mission, discard this card. Jetpacks, 1 influence. Keep this card secret. During any mission, when you deploy a group of small figures, you may place this card on that group. Figures in that group gain mobile. At the end of the mission, or when all figures in that group are defeated, either discard this card or shuffle it back into your agenda deck. Alright, so that's interesting. So let's look at the... let's look at these cards here. These are the story mission cards. We've got Hostile Negotiations, Story Mission, Hostile Negotiations, page 18. Overcharge, Story Mission, Overcharge, page 20. Trophy Hunting, Story Mission, Trophy Hunting, page 22. Turf War, Story Mission, Turf War, page 24. Moment of Fate, Story Mission, Moment of Fate, page 26, Jabba's Realm. It's got the Sarlacc pictured on it, which is cool. Story Mission, From All Sides, page 28, Jabba's Realm. Dangerous Allies, Story Mission, Dangerous Allies, page 30, Jabba's Realm. Story Mission, Almost Home, page 32. Execute the Plan, page 34. Storming the Palace, page 36. Mutiny, page 38. So that's the Story Mission cards. Let's get those out of the way. And we'll look at these, which are the reward cards, missions. Side mission, Perilous Hunt, page 14. Extortion, Ando Facility, side mission, Perilous Hunt was in the Wastes. Side mission, Perilous Hunt, page 14. Reward credits. Woo, money. Extortion, Ando Facility, side mission, Extortion, page 15. Reward, Haymaker reward card. A hero's welcome. Rhodia Outskirts. Rhodians, that's what those Greedo guys are called. A hero's welcome, page 16. Reward, Desperado reward card. Born from Death, Mandalore facility. Side mission, Born from Death, page 17. Reward, Mandalorian heritage reward card. Alright, so now let's look at the skirmish cards. There's four of them here, so let's see what we got. We've got the Pit of Carcoon. Desert Dangers. Neutral mission tokens represent installations. Doors are locked. A figure can attack a door, health 5, defense 2. When a figure is pushed into a space on the Sarlacc pit, that figure is defeated. End of each round, starting with the eastmost figures. Each figure on an exterior space is pushed one space to the east if possible. Then each player gains 3 VPs for each installation he controls. The Pit of Carcoon. Battle for the Nedana? I don't know. Neutral mission tokens represent installations. Doors are locked. A figure can attack a door. Health 5, defense 2. End of each round, each player gains 3 VPs for each installation he controls. Then if a player controls the cannon, that player may choose a space, and roll 1 red die. Each figure in that space suffers damage equal to the damage results. Nalhutta Borderlands. A. Enemy of my enemy. 4-player team battle. Neutral mission tokens represent turrets. Rebel mission tokens represent outposts. Start of each round. For each turret a team controls, that team chooses a space and rolls 1 green die. Each figure in each of the chosen spaces simultaneously suffers damage equal to the damage results. At the end of each round, for each outpost a team controls, that team gains 2 VPs. Now, Hutta Borderlands, Mission B, Border Dispute, 4-player free-for-all. Neutral mission tokens represent turrets. Rebel mission tokens represent outposts. Start of each round. For each turret he controls, each player chooses a space and rolls 1 green die. Each figure in each of the chosen spaces simultaneously suffers damage equal to the damage results. End of each round. For each outpost a player controls, that player gains 2 VPs. Alright, cool. So that's all the skirmishes. Now let's look at our character cards here. Let's start with the Alliance. We have Alliance Ranger, 9/3, Trooper Hunter, +1 accuracy, Surge +2 damage, Surge Pierce 1, Surge +2 accuracy. Gorilla, after you resolve an attack, if the defender was defeated, become hidden. Sniper, while attacking, if the target space is 5 or more spaces away, you may reroll 1 attack die. Health 5, speed 4, defense of 1 black die, attack of 2, blaster 2 blue. Blaster 2 blue. Can't talk today. Luke Skywalker, Jedi Knight, Force User, Leader, Brawler, 12 points. Plus 1 damage, plus 1 cancel, surge plus 1 damage, surge pierce 3. Deflect, after a blaster attack targeting you or an adjacent friendly figure resolves, a hostile figure of your choice in your line of sight suffers 1 damage. Heroic, once during your activation, you may perform an attack without spending an action. Health 16, speed 4, defense 1 white die, attack melee of 1 blue, 1 green, 1 yellow. Alright, let's get into this big stack of mercenaries here. See what these guys have for us. Wee Kuei Pirate, 5/3, Hunter Smuggler. Plus 1 accuracy, surge of one plus 1 damage, surge plus 1 accuracy, Raider. While attacking, you may choose one die. The player that rolled that die must reroll that die. Health 4, speed 4, defense of 1 black die, attack blaster 2 green dice. There's another Wee Kuei Pirate. It looks exactly the same. Okay. Wee Kuei Pirate, 7/4, Hunter Smuggler. Plus 2 accuracy, surge of plus 2 damage, surge pierce 1, surge plus 2 accuracy, and it's deplete prowl, you become hidden. Raider, while attacking, you may choose one die. The player that rolled that die must reroll that die. Health of 6, speed of 4, defense 1 black die, attack blaster 2 green dice. Gamorrean Guard. Brawler Guardian, 6/3, Gamorrean Honor. While defending during a blast attack, you may reroll 1 defense die. Labored Attack, while attacking, you may suffer 1 exhaustion to reroll 1 attack die. Health 5, speed 4, defense of 1 black die, melee of 2 red dice. And there are 2 cards of that. Gamorrean Guard, 8/4, Brawler Guardian. Reach, surge, cleave, 2 damage. Gamorrean Honor Guard. While defending during a blaster attack, you apply plus 1 defense to the defense results. Professional. While attacking, you may reroll 1 attack die. Health of 8, speed 4, defense 1 black die, attack 2 red melee. And here we go with the Rancor. Rancor Campaign. 10 points, creature brawler. Massive, reach, plus 1 defense. Surge, plus 3 damage. Surge, cleave, 2 damage. Deplete, throw, push a small figure within 2 spaces, up to 2 spaces. Then that figure suffers 2 damage. Feed, at the start or end of your activation, you may choose another friendly figure within 2 spaces. Recover damage equal to its health minus the damage it has suffered. That figure is defeated. Non-sentient. You cannot interact. Health 15. Speed 4. Defense 1 black die. Attack 1 red, 2 green. Rancor Skirmish. Creature Brawler. 10 points. Massive. Reach. Surge plus 2 damage. Surge cleave 2 damage. Exhaust Brutality. Perform 2 attacks. Each attack must have different targets. Non-sentient, you cannot interact. Trained, at the start of each round, you may add 1 block die, or black die to your defense pool during this round. If you do, lose brutality and non-sentient during this round. Health 15, speed 4, defense 1 black die, attack 1 red, 2 green. So the stats are basically the same, but it's got different specials like you'd expect. Alright, Jabba the Hutt Campaign, Vile Gangster, Leader, Smuggler, Hunter, 6 points. Deplete Bully, a figure of your choice within 3 spaces suffers 3 exhaustion. Deplete Execution Order, Another mercenary figure of your choice may interrupt to perform an attack. Deplete financial incentive. A friendly figure of your choice recovers 2 damage and becomes focused. Deplete plot. Increase Imperial by 2. Hut Syndicate. If you are on the map at the end of the mission, the Imperial player may gain 1 influence. Health 10, speed 2, defense 1 black die, attack of 1 red, 1 green. Alright, Jabba the Hutt, skirmish, vile gangster, leader, smuggler, hunter, 6 points. Deplete bully, a figure of your choice within 3 spaces suffers 3 exhaustion. Deplete incentivize, 1 mercenary figure of your choice becomes focused. Deplete scheme, draw 1 command card. Deplete, order hit, spend 2 VPs. A mercenary figure of your choice may interrupt to perform an attack, then it gains 2 movement points. Nefarious gains. When a hostile figure is defeated, gain 1 VP. Health 10, speed 2, defense 1 black die, attack of melee 1 red, 1 green. Shayla Varad, skirmish. There's only skirmishes for that. Alright, 8 points. Brawler Hunter. Plus 1 cancel. Surge plus 2 damage. Surge pierce 2. Surge cleave 2 damage. Deplete Mandalorian Whip. Choose a small hostile figure within 3 spaces in line of sight. Push that figure up to 3 spaces to a space adjacent to you. Then perform an attack targeting that figure. Responsive. At the start of your activation, you may gain 1 movement point or recover 1 damage. Health 12, speed 4, defense of 1 black die, attack melee 2 green, 1 yellow. Vito Herida, skirmish hunter smuggler, 5 points. Surge plus 1 damage, weaken. Surge pierce 2, bleed. Surge plus 2 accuracy, hide. Deplete rapid fire, perform 2 attacks. Bolt slinger, after you resolve an attack during your activation, you may choose a hostile figure other than the defender in your line of sight within 3 spaces of you. That figure suffers 1 damage. Health 8, speed 5, defense 1 white die, attack blaster 1 blue, 1 green. Onar Koma, skirmish, guardian hunter 6 points. Surge of plus 2 damage, negative 2 accuracy. Surge plus 1 damage, 1 accuracy. Plus 1 accuracy. Minus 1 accuracy. I can't talk. Deplete rush, move up to 4 spaces. Then you may push an adjacent small figure up to 1 space. If you do, you and that figure suffer 1 damage. Get down. When a small figure within 2 spaces is defending, you may apply plus 1 defense or plus 1 cancel to the defense results. Limit once per round. Immune. You cannot gain harmful conditions. Health 15, speed 4, no defense. Attack blaster 1 blue, 1 red, 1 green. He's still pretty good. Indentured Jester, skirmish upgrade, 1 point. Attachment. Unique figure only. At the start of this mission, place the Salacious B. Crumb companion in your space. Salacious B. Crumb activates at the start or end of your activation. Salacious B. Crumb is not counted for the purposes of control. And lastly, the Imperial cards. Jet Trooper, 4/2, Trooper Vehicle. Mobile, Surge plus 1 damage, Surge plus 2 accuracy. Agile. While defending, you may convert 1 defense to 1 cancel. Jets. After you resolve an attack, if the target space is within 2 spaces, gain 1 movement point. Health 3, speed 4, 1 black die defense, attack blaster 1 blue, 1 green. And there are 2 of those cards. Jet Trooper, red border. Trooper Vehicle, 7/4, Mobile, Surge plus 2 damage, Surge plus 3 accuracy. Agile, while defending, you may convert 1 damage to 1 cancel. Flyby, when you declare an attack, if the target space is within 2 spaces, add 1 blue to your attack pool. After the attack resolves, gain 2 movement points. Health of 7, speed of 4, defense of 1 black die, Attack blaster, one blue, one green. Captain Tarot, Wasteland Enforcer, Trooper Leader Creature, 7 points. This is the trooper on the dewback. Surge of plus two damage, Surge Pierce 2, Exhaust Flamethrower. Choose a space within two spaces. Each other figure on or adjacent to that space suffers one damage and one exhaustion, then becomes weakened. Mounted, at the start of your activation, gain 3 movement points. Health 13, speed 5, defense of 1 black die, attack blaster of 1 blue, 1 green, 1 yellow. He's pretty cool. I definitely would field him. Do have the mini for him sitting over here. We're going to open that in another episode. Wyatt was awesome enough to buy that figure, so we'll open that one and see what he's about. How that sculpt looks, but there is a card token for him in this box. But that is everything inside the Imperial Assault Jabba's Realm expansion. And as always, thanks to Wyatt for letting me open all his cool Imperial Assault stuff. And Imperial Assault Week continues in the next episode, where we're going to open some more minis. Until then, that'll do it for this episode. As always, thanks for watching, and we hope to see you next time on What's Inside.